Ranga Prakashaya Vithalaya Namo Namaha Marutputraya Kavaye Bhimaya Bhayaharine Shrimadananda Tirthaya Prakhyataya Namo Namaha Shivatanaya Varishtam Sarva Kalyana Murtim Parashukamarahastam Shobitam Modakena Aruna Kusumamala Vyala Lambodaram Tam Mamardaya Nivasam Shri Ganesham Namami Krishna Prata Krishna Manusmaranta Ratrocha Krishna Punaruttidai Te Krishna Deha Pravishanti Krishna Ajyam Yatha Mantra Hutam Hutashi Ramaya Rama Bhadraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Buddhirbalam Yashodhiryam Nirbhayatvam Arogata Ajadhyam Vakpadutvam Cha Hanumasmarana Bhave Chitre Padaischa Gambhire Vakyamane Rakhandite Guru Bhavam Vyanjayanti Bhati Shri Jayatirthavat Pranamatkamadhenum Cha Bhajat Suratarupam Shri Bhavabhoda Krupada Chintamani Mupasmahi Pujyaya Raghavendraya Satyadharvarataya Cha Bhajatam Kalpavrikshaya Namatam Kamadhenave Annapurne Sadapurne Shankara Pranavallabhe Jnana Vairagya Siddhartham Vikshyam Dehi Cha Parvati Hayagriva Hayagriva Hayagriviti Yode Tasya Nisrate Vani Jannu Kanya Prabhavat Raka Chandra Samana Kanti Vadaram Naka Dhirajastuta Muka Namapi Kurvati Suradhuni Parampara Pashupati Akarini Rajate Satyam Vidhatum Jalutya Bhashitam Vyaptim Chamurteshu Akhileshu Japmanah Adrushyata Atyat Mutarupam Uddham Tam Bhesabhayam Namrgam Namanusham Namrgam Namanusham Today's modern man has no time to pray. He has time for everything. Time for the gym. Time for the morning walk. Time for the newspaper. Time for the morning TV entertainment. He has time for everything, but 5 minutes to pray doesn't happen. Mahatma Gandhi used to say, I can give up my morning breakfast, but not my morning prayer. Prayer is empowering yourself. When you pray, you are drawing the infinite powers of the infinite into you. Children don't know how important it is to pray. Prayer is charging all my devotee friends who come with me to Tirumala. I tell them, right from the Mahadwara, right from Vaikuntham itself, please stop talking secular things. Just remember the Lord. Just walk through the queue, through the Mahadwara. Govinda, Govinda, Govinda. From the Mahadwara to the quadrangle, where you see the Balipita and the Vajasthambha. Then you have the next Dwara, and then take a left turn round Varadaraja Swami and come into the plain hall there, where you hear. Stop talking. Don't see anybody. Just see the Lord. focus on him. Few minutes, that's enough. Before that wonderful Telugu word Jargandi is told to you. Go focusing on the Lord. Catch as many glimpses as you can. Because the Jivatma is meeting the Paramatma. And as you walk in, you see his Makuta. You see the beautiful Tomala. You see the Urdhva Tilaka. You see the bejeweled earrings. You see the Shankha and Chakra. You see his shapely nose. You see his smiling cheeks. You see the smiling lips and the lovely chin and the Vishala Vakshastala. And then you have the Kaustubha. You have the two lovely sapphire jewels. And then you have Shridevi, Bhudevi, secular wealth and spiritual wealth. And then the girdle full of diamonds and the Nagasarpa. And from there you have the Lord's Abhaya Varada Hasta also full of diamonds. He was not wearing the diamond hand, he is wearing a golden hand with the words Mamekam Sharanam Braja. He is calling you to fall at his feet, to come to him and beckon him for his help, because he is the only one who can help us. And then you see the Tomala, then you see the Vaidyanti Mala, then you see the Lakshmi Sahasranam Mala, then you see the Salagrama Mala, and in between you see his lovely Pitambara. Just concentrate, just focus, come to the feet of the Lord, and there you find him. Vina Venkateshum Nanatho Nanatham Sada Venkateshum Smarami Smarami Hare Venkatesh Prasida Prasida Priyam Venkatesh Prayaccha Prayaccha. You have charged yourself. Is that clear? You have charged. You don't need any other charging. That 1 minute charging is enough. But one little charging. Cameras are forbidden in the temple. But I have a secret camera here. And I always catch a photo every time I go, so that I can tell my listeners, here is Narayana, focus. This is what Bharata did every day. Standing before the Paduka, he saw Sri Rama and said, this is my problem. Yada hi yat karyam upayeti kinchitam upayanam chopakritam maharham sa paduka bhyam pratamam nivedya chakara pachat bharato yatavat. Things are mentioned in this shloka. One is the problem. When you have a problem, talk to him. Please don't take the mobile and call people who already have problems. You will end up with two problems. Their problem and your problem. Both unsolved. Talk to somebody who doesn't have a problem. Please talk to him. But you will say, Amma, how do we get the answer? You will get the answer. How many people send you SMS? You think he can't send you an SMS? You think he can't send you an SMS? You say, I got a flash. No, 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 you didn't get a flash. He sent a flash. Please clap for him. He sends a flash. When you sit in total concentration, you get a flash. That flash comes from the Lord. And in the moments of prayer, these flashes are very easy to get. The second, whenever the boss is on leave and the secretary receives a gift for the boss, we can't think it is his gift. It is to be given to the boss. One day I wrote a story for Bharata and his wife Mandavi. One day somebody brought a Navaratna Hara, huge Hara, to be given to Sri Rama, and this Hara was kept near the Paduka. My lord's brother Bharata wants to test his wife, because all temptation comes only from the wife. If every wife of an officer said, I don't want you to take bribes, no officer would be corrupt. I wish every wife would be satisfied with what her husband gave her. Bharata looks at the Navaratna Hara and then looks at his wife. His wife is more clever and dedicated. She looks at the Paduka. That is the end of the story. Is that clear? I don't want the Navaratna Hara, Swami. What is Rama's. Everything is of Rama, by Rama, for Rama. This is how Bharata ruled. Whatever upayanam chopakritam maharham. It could have been the costliest gift that was given, but it was reserved for Rama. That is how a man should rule for his master. Days pass by. To make the long story short, my lord is moving further to the forest because he doesn't want to remain there. He thinks if he is close to Nandigrama, Bharata may come back. So he wants to move, shift quarters. So he's going further into the forest. As he is going, they meet Atri and Anasuya. Mother Anasuya is asking Mother Sita, why do you follow this fakir? Why do you follow this poor man? He doesn't even have a credit card. He doesn't have perquisites. He is traveling like a poor person through the forest, barefooted, eating fruits and roots. Why do you follow him? My mother looks at her and says, Yam vrittim vartate ram kausalyayam mahabalaha tamem nriparinam anyasamapi vartate. Why can't I follow him, mother? The way my Lord Rama looks at other women is as if he would look at Kausalya. That is the sterling character of my husband. I asked my sisters, you have a very good husband. He gives the best jewelry. He gives you the best house, he gives you the best car, and he has the best mistress. What would you say? Give her what she wants, come back, come back. Every woman wants a good husband with a sterling character. Whether it is Sri Rama and his guna or Sri Krishna and his guna. Shutva guna and bhuvana sundara shirvatante nirvishyakarna vivare haraturgatatam rupam drisham drishyamata madhilakthalabham tvayi achyuta avishati chittam apatrapamne. Mother Rukmini says, it's your guna, Krishna. It's your guna that makes me fall for you. So Sri Rama is known for his guna. My husband is so pure that he looks at every woman as his mother. That is why I love him. That is why I follow him. Mother Anasuya gives her lots of jewelry. Bow down to the Aranyakanda, which we are just starting now. Sri Rama is going into the forest and all the foresters come and do Sharanagati. Throughout the Ramayana, Sharanagati is the concept that is repeated again and again. Everybody comes and does Sharanagati to Rama. All Sharanagatis are successful except one. Then Rama does Sharanagati to the king of the ocean. That is the only Sharanagati which is unsuccessful. Sri Rama lies on the Darbashayana and wants the king of the ocean to come to him. The king of the ocean does not appear. And when he appears, when Rama is angry, he says, how can this be a Sharanagati, Rama? Only the superior has to be approached by the inferior, and the superior should not approach the inferior. That is why I did not appear. The whole of the Ramayana is full of Sharanagati. All the foresters come and tell him, the Rakshasas, who are of the dynasty of Ravana, are hurting us, troubling us. We want your help. The Lord says, I will help you. I have come here to help. And that is my duty. There is nothing in the world which keeps me away from performing the acts of dharma. I want you to rest assured that I will always stand by you. My dear devotees, the Lord is very sure of helping only the good people and destroying the evil. It is from the Krishna Avatara and the Bhagavad Gita that we learn, Yada Yada Yidharmasya Glanil Bhavati Bharata Abhyutthana Dharmasya Tadatmanam Sriyamyaham. Sri Rama has decided to kill all the Rakshasas who are in the way of good people. Everybody is welcoming Sri Rama into the forest and welcoming his pratignya to help the good people. There is a slight difference of opinion between Rama and Sita. A very interesting piece of conversation. When your husband is far superior to you, there is a way of talking to him and telling wives. But most wives say, how stupid you are. Totally common senseless. That is not the way my mother speaks. She is Janaka's daughter. She has a way of talking. Unfortunately, I think modern society has lost its language of decorum. We speak what we like and how we like. If your husband is like Rama, you can't say how wrong you are. Look at the lovely way she introduces the subject. Sri Rama, there are only three sinful things in the world. The Lord is looking at her. I know what you are driving. I know what you are going to say. Trinyeva Nasyanatra Kamajani Bhavantyutaha Mithyavakyam Gurutaram Tasmat Guru Gamehudi Taradara Vigaman Vina Vairam Charudrata Mithyavakyam Nate Bhutam Nabhavishyati Raghava Kuto Abhirashanam Strinam Parisham Dharmanashanam Tavanasti Manushyendra Racha Bhutte Kadachanam Swadara Niratastum Cha Nityame Madhupatmajam Tritiyam Yadidam Rautram Para Prana Vihimsanam Nirvairam Kriyate Mohat samupattitam. There are three evils in life. One is mithyavakya, falsehood. The second is adultery. Third is unwarranted violence. There are three things which are wrong. First is mithyavakyam, falsehood. I think if you ask a wife, how true is your husband? She can say, till today he is truthful. I'm not sure about tomorrow. But Mother Sita says, never will you tell a lie, Sri Rama. It's a prophecy about future character also. Mithyavakyam nate bhutam na bhavishyati Raghava. In your lifetime you will never tell a lie. What more do you want from a wife? Second, paradara vigavanam. How nicely she analyzes it. You love your life, wife so much that you have no time for other women. Svadara nivartastvam. Simple psychology. When does a man love another woman? When he is not interested in his wife. If you are too interested in svadara nivartastvam, what a lovely compliment for a husband. 24 hours you are doting on me, Sri Rama. You have no time to think of anyone else. How can you ever think of adultery? But then, this sankalpa to kill the rakshasas, what did they do to you? Why did you tell the foresters you will kill them? Tritiyam yadidam rudram paraprānābhi himsanam. Sita, says the Lord, he's angry. Righteous indignation. When someone approaches me for help, I promise. And to keep that promise, I can give up you, I can give up my life, I can give up Lakshman, anything in the world. Apyaham jivitam jakhyam tvam vasite salakshmanam natu pratignyam samshudya brahmanebhyo visheshatah. When I make a promise to the Brahmins, I will keep the promise. Even if I have to give you up, you have to give up my life, you have to give up Lakshmanam. She knows she has irritated him. She understands, yes. For you, your satya pratigna is important, not. You want to protect the Brahmins. I will not talk against you. My master meets Agastya. My master meets Jatayu, who promises that he will help whenever they need help. And a beautiful place they reach called Panchavati. Today, if you want to build your bungalow, your villa, you tell the architect, I want a nice location, I want a nice place, lot of foliage, lot of lakes and all that. But if you have a lake behind your house, or a river behind your house, or a sea behind your house, naturally the price goes up. You want a lovely location. So here, who is the architect? Lakshmana. Lakshmana, please build a cottage where Ramate yatra vaidehi tvam aham chaiva Lakshmana. Please find a place. Vana ramanyakam yatra jala ramanyakam tatha. I want lots of trees. I want a lot of water places. And I want the most beautiful atmosphere where you are happy, where Sita is happy, and where I am happy. Generally people build a house and tell the architect, master bedroom for me, smaller room for my brother, smallest room for the guest without AC so that he will depart. Please, have a guest house very nice so that Atithi feels Atithi Devo Bhava. Look at the Lord's selflessness. Where you will be happy, where Sita will be happy, and finally I will be happy. Ultimately it doesn't matter to me, it's you who matter. Lakshmana says, I don't even want staff quarters, my Lord. I am your slave, not the 14 years contract. I am your slave for births to come. Paravanasmi kakustam toyi varshashatam. Don't think I have come to serve you for 14 years, Rama. I am your servant for hundreds of years. Hundreds of years. I am not on a job contract. People wait to see 5 o'clock the day. That's all. They are gone. 5 o'clock they are waiting. 95 job. No, that is not the way Lakshmana behaves. Lakshmana is a slave all his life and beyond. I will always be there. The Lord is very happy when a beautiful cottage is built. And the cottage is so modern that the river is flowing through the chamber of Mother Sita. She can have a private bath. It's a beautiful place. Everything is arranged. And the architect and the contractor take you around the house. No? The Lord is taken around the house. He's very happy. And then he tells something which we will remember all our life. Generally, the father leaves the house for the son. Today, Rama says, Lakshmana, you have replaced my father Dashratha by giving me a beautiful cottage. The younger brother has superseded the father. What a lovely compliment to pay. Praya Prena Dharmatma Nasamrita Pita Mama. Everything is happy, everything is fine, and the Lord, Mother Sita and Lakshmana are leading a very nice life. Mother Sita and the Lord are sitting quietly outside their cottage, and Lakshmana is picking flowers and fruits. Somebody come, something happens. Tathasinatyamatya kathasam tattachetataha tam desham rakshasi kachit ajagamaya drichaya. I told you when Mantara is ascending the stair to find out what is happening in the balcony of Kausalya's palace, Yadrichaya word is used. Yadrichaya means Bhagavat Ichha, says the Ramayana commentator. Another Yadrichaya is now that Rakshasi Kashurpanaka is entering.